हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल ज्ञान रसायन। माय सेल्फ यस वी स्वामी एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस न्यूटन्स यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन। एज वी नो द ग्रेविटी कॉन्सेप्ट इनिशियली पुट फोर्थ बाय सर आइज़ैक न्यूटन एंड लेटर ऑन इट वॉज डिराइव्ड and expanded into Newton's universal law of gravitation. So briefly, if I discussed with the gravity concept, it was a very limited concept because it was related with only the surface, only the objects present on the Earth's surface. But the Newton's universal law of gravitation is very broad concept. It is a very expanded concept. So today let us discuss and begin with the universal law, Newton's universal law of gravitation. So first of all, I will put here the statement of Newton's universal law. So let us begin with the statement. Dear friends, the statement says that every object attracts every other objects in the universe then with a definite force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. Okay, so look at here, friends. Every objects in the universe attracts every other object with a definite force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So initially, let me clear this. Sir Isaac Newton given this statement in 1687. So this law was initially first invented in this year. Later on, let us study regarding with the concept. So this is a very, as already told, that is, it is a broad concept. Consider two objects. Suppose this is the object one, this is the object second. So let us consider the mass of first object be m1, mass of second object be m2. So these are the masses. So the distance between them was found to be, let us connect them with their centers, and let us denote it as d is the distance between these two objects. Then definitely, according to the universal law, every two objects get attracted towards each other. So definitely M1 and M2 masses having objects will definitely attract to each other. In between them, the distance was found to be D. Then according to Newton's universal law of gravitation, the gravitational force F between these two objects was found to be multiplication, that is the product of first object mass and second object mass. That means the masses between them, product of masses between them was directly be found to be directly proportional to the F. In second case, if I found that the force of gravitation was found to be inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them, as it is F is inversely proportional to D square. If we merge these two statements, these two equations, we'll found that F will be directly proportional to M1 into M2 divided by D square. And let us make it simplify in the equation form. Just by removing the proportionality sign, it will turn into F equal to G into M1 into M2 divided by D square. So this is called as the statement, mathematical equation for Newton's universal law of gravitation, where F is the gravitational force, G is called as gravitational constant, M1 and M2 are the masses of objects, and D square, D is nothing but the distance between these two objects. As this relation indicates that F is directly proportional to product of their masses, it means that the mass, look at here, if mass increases, mass of the object goes on increasing, definitely the gravitational force also goes on increasing. So very interesting concept it is. If the mass increases of the objects, then definitely it increases the force of gravity, gravitational force. Secondly, which is the second relation, which indicates the F is inversely proportional to 1 by D square. So it means that if the distance between them goes on increasing, then the gravitational force will be definitely reduced, decrease. And there is a definitely, if suppose if it is square, then definitely it depends upon, it reduces by 1 divided by 4th. If it is, it becomes half. If the distance becomes half, definitely it will increase by 1 by 4th times that of the original gravitational force. If we replace or simplify this statement in the terms of G, which is called as gravitational constant, so it can be written as G equal to F into D square divided by M1 into M2. It will give us the Newton's gravitational constant. If we check this unit of this gravitational constant, let me first write here gravitation. What is G? It is the gravitational constant. Gravitational constant. So, G is gravitational constant, which gives the unit. All of we know, F has the unit Newton. D is the distance, which is measured in meter squares, divided by mass of first object kilogram into second. Finally, it will give us Newton meter square per kilogram square will be the unit of Newton's universal law of gravitational constant G. So finally we come to this conclusion, the universal law, Newton's universal constant, Newton's law is universal, it is applicable for everywhere in the universe, for different planets, for different stars, for different objects present in the even space. So definitely let me know that whether you are getting this concept or not. So I request all of you dear friends, if you conclude or if you definitely understood all this concept, definitely share me your feelings, your queries, your doubts. Definitely if you have some doubts, you can ask me, I will definitely reply it, and share this concept with your friends also. Thank you for watching my video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel Gyan Rasayan. Thank you.